During the week of this summit, several heads of states made it a point in their statements to thank the United States and to thank me personally for all that NATO has achieved. NATO is not only stronger, NATO is bigger because we led the charge to bring in Finland and Sweden into the alliance, and it makes a gigantic difference. Excuse me. Meanwhile, my predecessor has made it clear he has no commitment to NATO. He's made it clear that he would feel no obligation to honor Article 5. He's already told Putin, and I quote, do whatever the hell you want. In fact, the day after Putin invaded Ukraine, here's what he said. It was genius. It was wonderful. Some of you forgot that, but that's exactly what he said. But I made it clear, a strong NATO is essential to American security. And I believe the obligation of Article 5 is sacred. And I would remind all Americans, Article 5 is invoked only once in NATO's long history, and that was to defend America after 9/11. I made it clear that I will not bow down to Putin. I will not walk away from Ukraine. I will keep NATO strong. That's exactly what we did and exactly what we'll continue to do. Now, the future of American policy is up to the American people. This is much more than the political question. It's more than that. It's a national security issue. Don't reduce this to the usual testament that people talk about, issues of being a political campaign. It's far too important. It's about the world we live in for decades to come. Every American must ask herself or himself, is the world safer with NATO? Are you safer? Is your family safer? I believe the American people know the answer to all those questions is yes. And I believe the American people understand that America is stronger because of our alliances.